Hey, what's happening? So I'm just making dinner right now. Couple of things. Listen, you've heard a lot about back pain over the past week, and that's because my buddy Rick Kaselj has come out with a back pain product. Now, number one, I told you in a previous email that if you're swinging your kettlebells the right way, like the way that I showed you, chances of you having back pain are pretty much zero, like nothing. Why? Because that's the beauty of the kettlebell swing. It'll help bulletproof your back. You'll become stronger in your core, stronger in your glutes, stronger in your quads, and that'll give you a nice strong back, right? But the fact of the matter is that sometimes our hips get tight, you know, because we sit down too much or whatever. And so I asked Rick to film me a video about tight hips and how that relates to the back. Now, I agree with pretty much everything that Rick does. His anatomy in this video is spot on. His explanation of the stretches are spot on. And the way he kind of manipulates the model to show you the different curves in your spine is spot on. I agree with all of that. The one thing that I don't agree with is his shirt. Just watch the video.
Hey, this is Rick Kaselj from exercisesforinjuries.com and Fix My Back Pain. This is a special video for Chris Lopez and everyone over at Kettlebell Workouts. So Chris asked if I can answer a question when it comes to how your hip flexors can end up affecting your back. So if we end up looking at the hip flexors, they end up being in two parts. You know, one of your quadriceps end up being part of your hip flexors, so helping you when it comes to hip movement. And then also deep in our pelvis, connected to our spine, is another set of hip flexors. So it would end up being rectus femoris is the ones in the quadriceps, and then deeper ends up being psoas and iliacus. So what ends up happening, I'll get Orsi to show, and looking from the side, if we end up being good, what ends up happening is our back, I'll get you to just put, yeah, like that. Our low back ends up being in a good position. But if things end up being tight in those hip flexors, what ends up doing is it ends up changing that curve in your lower back. So it ends up tilting that pelvis forward and increasing that curve in the lower back. And when we end up losing or changing that curve in the lower back, it ends up putting you at greater risk when it comes to your back, when it relates to injury or pain. So what we want to do is make sure that those hip flexors have good flexibility, good movement, especially if you end up doing a lot of sitting throughout the day when it relates to driving, computer work, office work, because that sitting ends up shortening up the hip flexors, which puts your back at greater risk. So two stretches that you can end up doing is like a standing hip flexor stretch. So Orsi's got it taking a big step, front foot is flat, she's on the back toe of the back foot, she's end up tightening her abdominal areas, tighten her glutes, and just bring her hips forward a little bit, and she's looking at getting a stretch in that hip area. What I end up doing when it relates to stretching, twice on each side, holding for 20 to 30 seconds. So switching on the other side, good. And then bringing the hips forward a little bit in order to intensify that stretch. So this is something that you can end up doing anywhere. You can end up doing it even at work. One that I like that's a little bit more intense ends up being like a 90-90 hip flexor stretch. So Orsi's nice and upright. She's gonna tighten her abdominal area. She's gonna end up tightening her glutes and then bringing her hips forward. Okay, in order to stretch out more that hip flexor that's in the quadriceps. And same thing, twice on each side, holding for about 20 seconds. Okay, good. Tighten the abdominal area, bringing the hips forward, looking at stretching out that rectus femoris. And once again, this is one that you can easily end up doing anywhere quickly in the office in order to stretch out that hip flexor and kind of counteract all that shortening that you end up having throughout the day from sitting throughout the day from driving and office work and computer work. So there you go. Everyone at Kettlebell Workouts and Chris Lopez, there's a quick tip when it comes to why hip flexors or how hip flexors can end up affecting your back and why it's important to end up having those hip flexors loose and good movement within those hip flexors. So this is Rick Kaselj from exercisesforinjuries.com and Fix My Back Pain saying take care and bye-bye.